What is up, Spaggots? I decided I am going to make this YouTube channel more betterer. Yes, that is great grammar. I am going to get better edited videos. I am going to try to make this the best edited video I've ever had yet. I know I won't get nearly as much views as that How to Rip Athletic Tape video, but this, my friends, is Spags 101. So, I grew up in Harrisburg. I don't know if y'all will be able to see it, but I'm at my Harrisburg house now, and I don't know what the lighting, if you'll be able to see it, but my nearest neighbor is right across the way. Maybe if I turn my light off. My nearest neighbor's right there. About maybe 50 feet away. Yeah, pretty much everybody knows everybody here. I played, you know, the local Little League at the field at Taylor Park, and, you know, it was just a blast. But I got into some crazy stuff down here. You know, it wasn't all happy-go-lucky for me, you know. It was a learning experience. While I was here, I've learned so much. I've learned valuable life lessons. And so this, my friends, like I said, is Spags 101. I am almost 17 years old. I turned 17 in like 3 weeks. And this is where I've lived my whole life. I just moved to E-Town. But, yeah. I've had a lot of bad stuff going on in my life. In 2014 was a bad year. You know, one of my good friends that I had gym class with, He drowned in the pool at his one house.
Bruh.
In his apartment near the new Target that they built there, Colonial Commons or whatever it's called, near there. And, that summer was pretty bad. But, like I said, I haven't, you know, this place where I'm at right now, in Harrisburg, you know, it gives me nostalgia, because this is where I grew up, you know, this is where all my memories come from, between, you know, playing Friday Night Lights, or playing Little League, you know, soccer, basketball, you know, this is my home, and it always will be my home. In order to truly understand the Spags, you have to understand, I like to read, and I like baseball. I like baseball fans. This is Matt Holliday. But anyway, yeah. So a little bit about me. like I said, I was born in Harrisburg, born and raised in Harrisburg. Played baseball, basketball, football, soccer, rugby, on teams. I've played a lot of other stuff not on the team, but competitively. Like, I've played water polo, but I wouldn't consider myself a water polo player. And I've played, what else? I've played badminton, volleyball. I wouldn't consider myself volleyball players, though. Heck no. I don't have anything against volleyball. It's just I'm terrible at it. But, yeah. Also, I'm a diehard Pittsburgh fan. Let me see if I can show you Big Ben right here. Where's Big Ben? There's Big Ben. And if you guys can't read it, it says, "The biggest thing isn't necessarily how I play, but that we win. That's my number one goal." Ben Roethlisberger. And, as you guys know, like I said, I'm a big fan of baseball. So, I don't know if you can see that, but this is from Earl Weaver. This says, "You can't sit on a lead and run a few plays into the line and just kill the clock. You've got to throw the ball over the damn plate and give the other man his chance. That's why baseball is the greatest game of all time." Try to argue with me on that one, I will kill you. But, yeah, baseball is the greatest game of all time. And, also, I am a fan of Dude Perfect, so Dude Perfect, if you're watching this, hit me up, because I got your Nerf shit. And
I am a multi-sport person. That is right. I am a multi-sport person. I have played a multitude of sports throughout my life, and it has impacted me in so many ways.
Through these different sports, I have learned multiple characteristics. One, how to be a good teammate. Two, winning isn't everything, you know, just play your heart out. And three, I've learned how to get better at sports. You know? Winning isn't everything. Yes, winning is great. Everyone wants to win. Everyone wants to win. Every kid has a dream. Most of the kids playing Little League, yes, this seems absurd, but most of the kids playing Little League, you ask them, it's like, oh, I want to play professional baseball. You do you. I am and was one of those kids. I want to play professional baseball. Chasing the dream starts now, boys. Look at all these trophies. Look at all those trophies, my dude. I got one for soccer. I was goalie every year in soccer. Got one for basketball. Another one for basketball. Dang it. Got one for baseball. Got one for bowling. I was a heck of a bowler. Look at that. High game. HG113 HS205. I was only six or seven. You gotta admit, that's pretty impressive. Got another one for baseball. This is my favorite trophy. I got this at a Harper Senators game when our team got recognized for outstanding record. But another one for soccer. And my last one is a soccer trophy. 2012. Flashback. But, yeah. I don't keep these trophies just to brag. You know, it's a learning experience. And through learning, you build knowledge and wisdom and certain characteristics that you would want. And I try to be a good person, you know. I'm starting a leadership academy at church. You know, church plays a big role in my life. When I was little, I doubted God for a little bit. I ain't gonna lie. I was going through a lot, and I was just like, oh, God's not real. God hates me, or God whatever. But now I realize God just has different plans for everybody. Whether it's, you know, he doesn't want to see you fail. He wants to see you succeed and get into heaven. He doesn't want to see you self-destruct. God's plan for everybody is different. For Evan Gattis, a World Series champion. He was a janitor a decade ago. If Evan Gattis can go from janitor to World Series champion, just imagine. You can go from, I don't know, a normal doctor to a scientist, a famous scientist, you know. Sky's the limit. So my message after this documentary about me, my message is dream big, go hard, or go home. Spec it out.